I'm sensing a connection here. I'm so sorry, that was terrible. What was I thinking? Hey guys, it's G from the F Word here to review Sense 8 Season 1. Now, I wasn't really going to do this one, but someone commented in one of my other videos and asked me if I could do it, so I'm always up for suggestions from the fans to do stuff, especially when I've never seen it, of course. So, Joel Andres, this is for you. So what is Sense 8? Sense 8 is 8 people who are connected. They're from different parts of the world. They are connected through a few different things. A, the ability to connect, which makes them something called Sense 8s, and there have been other Sense 8s before them. If I remember the term, it was clusters of Sense 8s. And also there's 8 of them, and they have this sense ability. Title Sense 8, they are Sense 8s. It makes sense. And so they're all connected through an event that happens that almost triggers this whole thing and their ability to a sense. A quite traumatic thing that happens. Not only are they trying to figure out what happened with that event, but also how they're able to do this, why they're able to do this, realizing that they need each other to help each other in not only their own personal situations, but also the fact that there's this evil organization run by a man named Whisper that's after them and wants to pretty much wipe them out. They're also kind of led Nick Fury style by Naveen Andrews' character, who is Jonas, who is a sensate himself, and he is there to help guide them and help bring them together, and when he's not being overly vague. I can imagine it's like a Mr. Miyagi thing where you want to figure it out yourself. If you know anything about the Wachowskis, you know 2 things. They are revolutionary directors, especially when you're talking about The Matrix, and also they are transgender, which plays a lot into this show. Essentially, this show is about being able to connect no matter where you are in the world, and accepting other people as how they are. In fact, one of our main characters, a character named Nomi, she is a transgender herself in the show and in real life. So that plays a lot into it, and it really adds to the authenticity of it. All the characters in here really play into the authenticity. We've got representations in Mumbai, Berlin, Seoul, Nairobi, in Kenya, for those of you who don't know, Chicago, in Iceland. So their ability is that powerful that they're able to connect that far out. Our main characters, one, as I mentioned, was Nomi. We've got Will, we've got Riley, we've got Sun, we've got Wolfgang, we've got Kala, we've got Capheus, and we have Lito. Each individuals that wouldn't really connect to anything, right? But they're all, essentially, you're looking at, as I said, one spirit with 8 branches. At least that's the best way that I can explain it. I mean, I'm gonna be straight up. I really enjoyed this. I thought it was really cool, and I am so looking forward to starting season 2 as soon as I'm done this review. It was really interesting, and it had really powerful messages, and it had good representation of all the characters and their background, and then also their cultural representations from different parts of the world. And somehow, some way, they are able to connect with each other. These are special individuals who, for lack of a better term, sense that in each other. And it was really well done how the Wachowskis, along with the creator of Babylon 5, were able to show that in a way that not just seemed plausible, but seemed like it made sense. Like sometimes when you get into theories like this, even if you're dealing with time travel, it gets very complicated, and there's a lot of moments where like, I don't buy that because it didn't tie into how you did it before, and continuity is really tough to do, but I was impressed at how well the continuity was in this, because it is quite a layered concept with a lot of different parts to it. It's borderline impossible for me to contemplate this, so for them to be able to put it in a way that I could buy, yeah. Thumbs up for that. All the performances were pretty good. There was a couple that were weaker than others, but that always happens. But I did like a lot of the characters. I like their backstories. I like their individual stories. This had a very Lost feel to it. And because they were on location so many places, that was really cool. You don't get that too often, and there was a lot of locations here. So the authenticity is off the charts, and it looked really cool. The colors were great in this too. It's another thing. Like, it just, it was really bright. Everything had its own kind of feel based on the color tone of the area that they were in the situation. And I will also commend the progression and pace of it. The progression on how the characters discovered their abilities and how one connected with the other and how they showed that really was done in a great way. It was very gradual, and at the end of every episode and sometimes in the beginning, there are moments where that ability is better. They get better at being able to connect. So the progression in general through all the characters was really good. And the fact that they're learning this ability and are strengthening that ability, and the more and more they use it, and the more they find ways to connect with each other, and the more and more they can all connect together, the stronger their ability is. And that was showcased really good in this. And of course, it's got a really good message of acceptance and being able to connect with people that you otherwise may not think you would connect to from different parts of the world. We are all connected in one way, shape, or form. And so that's a lot of the main themes behind this. I don't have too many negatives. I will say that it does get heavy-handed in its message. The message is good. The message is important. But it does tend to really hammer that into the audience. And if you're a cynical viewer, I can understand how you may not appreciate this as much. And you might just see this as a sermon more than just entertainment. I'm not as cynical, so I bought into a lot of the stuff there. And I was allowing it to show me what it wanted me to show me. But it still sometimes was just a little bit heavy-handed. There was some pretty interesting scenes in here. There's some images in here that I don't think I'll be getting out of my head anytime soon. And it's not necessarily bad. It's just, it happens and boom. Like, especially towards the second last episode, I think it was. There was a series of stuff and you're like, oh wow, they totally went there. It didn't put me off too much, but you know, again, this kind of goes back to really forcing that for you to just get into it. Not all the performances were great. There were some characters that followed into that heavy-handed nature, and they also didn't have the best line delivery. It felt a little flat and a little bit more red than anything. It was more prevalent in the earlier episodes than it was towards the end of the first season. So it definitely does get better. But again, not all actors are the same, and some people you're going to connect with more than others. And one of the sensates I felt was almost unnecessary. And I don't know if it was because of the timing of when he was able to discover his ability or just his storyline in connection to everybody else and what he was able to offer to the rest of them. I felt was almost unnecessary. I'm not going to say who because I don't want to influence your thoughts in any way, shape, or form. But it was kind of one of those things where you almost could have swapped that character out entirely and just made 7 of them, even though it wouldn't make sense. Or made that character a little bit more relevant because the rest of them were. I would argue 1, maybe 2, but it depends on how you're looking at it and how you feel about each person. I will say that that particular character storyline was very interesting. I don't know if it's just a season 1 thing and in season 2 it'll be more and more, but it felt like he was on his own thing while everybody else was somehow more so connected. So Sense8, I think it's worth checking out, and especially if you want something with a message that has some really cool scenes. Like, there are some pretty exceptional scenes in here, and the Wachowskis did not disappoint in that way at all. You also get a sense that there is a personal story here with the Wachowskis, especially given their transformation and how it relates to the tales in here. And again, it's a story about acceptance. It's a story about connecting with people no matter where you are in the world and how we all can truly connect with each other. Good, solid characters, some really cool storylines with each of those individual characters. I have a few favorites of my own, and I'm hoping in season 2, the ones that I wasn't a big fan of in the beginning get better there too. So overall, I think it's worth your time. I think it's worth checking out for sure. So that's my quick review of Sense8 season 1, non-spoiler. Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are. I'd love to hear from you. You can find me on Twitter at TheFWordsG. You can email me or us at TheFWordPodcast@gmail.com. Make sure you're following Entertain Facts on Instagram. You can also check us out on audio version of our live show and other one-on-ones I have on the podcast side on Anchor. Description to that link is below. And until next time, I'm G and I am out.